We have started our day today in a little town called St. Remy. We chose to come here because this is where Vincent van Gogh came when he wasn't well. And he did a lot of his landscapes and things while he was here. So it's very cool to see like what he actually saw to be able to create what he did. I don't necessarily buy and keep to the future or happiness, but I need a little place in the sun sometimes, or I think I will die. Oh, and everywhere is somewhere, nowhere is near. Everybody's got somebody with their wine and their beer. Okay, so we've just arrived at a place called Carrière de Lumière, and it's like this incredible stone, like you might be able to see it in the background a little bit. A stone quarry that's been dug out, and in the building they've used it as the background for the projection of artwork. And so as you walk in, you feel like you're walking into like Alice in Wonderland, because the floor's moving, the roof's moving, all the walls look like they're moving, and there's just images splashed around everywhere. Plus there's like this huge height and depth in the rooms, and it's really cold because it's stone. It just feels like another world. It's amazing. And there's music that goes along with the images, the way they move. Do you like it?
Yeah, I love it. It's wonderful. We'll try and capture footage, but it's very hard.
It's really dark in
there. But maybe not for you. With their wine and their beer, and I'm just this tragic figure in a corner over here.
Come home to an empty apartment and call a best friend who is it. So that was absolutely phenomenal. I couldn't get any video footage because our camera on the phone just was not good enough to capture it. So I will put in some pictures here. Cross the sea of loneliness, fight this red river of pain. To cross the sea of loneliness, fight this red river of pain. Cross the sea of loneliness. I want you to imagine that the ceilings were like 12 meters high, and then the pillars were like 10 meters wide, and we're in this vast space where there would have been like three or four different areas, and on all the walls and all the floor, the artwork just sort of
was projected on.
It was projected, but it had movement involved as well. And there was music playing to all of it. So it was just this incredible experience that you can't get anywhere else. Two things that were just an added bonus for me anyway, was that there were lots of little school groups going through, and I loved seeing all the little kids holding hands like ducklings following their teacher. And a song came on by Janis Joplin and they all went wild. They were all dancing and playing their air guitars, and it was good to see that her music has an international effect. And it was your favourite art gallery by far too, wasn't it?
Yeah, by far, hands down. And we've been to a few now in this trip, so
yeah,
that's the one you don't want to miss out on.
Yeah. I was dumb, I was fooling around, always searching for something I found, and I know I could die and I'd be happy. So darling, won't you come run away with me? Darling, won't you come run away with me? I've burnt every bridge and I've walked every street, and I've started to question what happiness means. So I just crawled up on this rock to get some film of that amazing little village over there, which we've just left, and the wind blew the car keys. They nearly went down there. Imagine that. We'd be screwed. Good morning, everyone. I couldn't even sleep last night. I was so excited. I kept waking up and remembering where I was and just wanting to get the day started. So before we do that, I want to give you a quick tour of where we're staying, because
This place is the kind of place I've always dreamt about. When I thought of coming to France, this is like the exact sort of villagey vibe I was hoping for. So let's go have a look.
So we're not staying in this gorgeous little place. We are staying in this enormous one.
Money's crap, and I'm done with this scene. And you're the only one who believes in me. So darling, won't you come?
Okay, so we've just arrived in La Roque-Gageac or something. I saw pictures of this on the internet and it looks exactly the same in real life. Just arrived in a place that I found on a blogger's recommendation, and the best part is because I have the worst memory the whole way here, I didn't know what we were going to, and Mitch kept saying, so what's going to be here when we get there, what are we going to do? I'm like, I don't know, I don't remember. But look what we found now.
Daughters of the seven seas, break my virtue tween and knees, tie the stones to my feet, let me be. Now I've gotta get away, still searching for that yesterday. I'll dance upon a rocky shore.
Okay, so what were your final impressions of La Poppy?
Well, I loved it for a start. It had beautiful architecture, which was quite unique to a lot of the villages we've been to. And gorgeous medieval streets that are just overgrown and, I don't know how to put it, just picturesque.
Yeah. And my final impression was that it was just stunning because it was so ancient. It felt like you're walking back in time, but people still live there. So it's sort of like, it's looked after, but the gardens are all wild and unruly. And it's just, it's a really lovely world to walk into.
Yeah. And it's on a hillside too, which is really intriguing, you know, just how it impacts the city streets and that sort of thing.
Yeah, we loved it.
Smoke walks the street as the chimneys burn.
Which is near the Switzerland border. We had some raw vegan food for breakfast this morning, which was delicious, but we do need to go and find
bagels. Everyone's got bagels.
Bagels. It's gonna have to happen. This maze I stand of concrete. Okay, so we came to Annecy because I saw amazing photos of that thing over there. And now we're here and it's all under construction, so it doesn't look nearly as pretty as it did in the photos. But luckily, Annecy is a really beautiful city anyway, so we'll go find something else to look at. Without